Yeah, good afternoon, YouTube. So I'm getting ready to start assembling some of these 20P battery packs here. So I've printed these in ABS plastic on my 3D printer. So I did red for the positive and black for the negative. That way I keep everything straight. And you put your 10 pair of cells in there. And then the way they work, your positive would be up like that. And then the idea is you run some sort of a bus wire down here in this channel that's in the side there. On the positive side, you hook up your fuse wire, solder to the middle of the tabbing there, and then up to that wire. And in the original design, I'll put a link to that video in the video description. The fellow that did the original design on these used some 10 amp rated household wiring that he stripped the insulation off of, and then he doubled the wire up and twisted it so that it was about that long. So this is about 6 inches roughly. So what he did was took twice that length and then twisted the wire together, left a little loop on the end, and then the idea was you stuck that loop in from this side. You stuck another wire with a loop from the other side, and then you used a self-tapping sheet metal screw down through that hole through the two loops to make your connection in the middle. And then for connecting battery packs together, he used another short length of looped wire that would go in there. When you put your packs together, you had to take the screw out, put your jumper wire in, put the screw back in. And I was thinking I wanted to make something a little bit less fiddly, and I had a bunch of this solid core copper wire. And actually this stuff here is 12 gauge, so that's rated at about 20 amps, which would be about what the original design used. And what I did here is I cut about a 6 inch long piece, and then I used a pair of needle nose pliers to bend a little bit of a hook on the end, and then hammered that copper flat just to give it more surface area. And then the idea here is I put those two hooks in, and they're just big enough to fit through this passageway in there, but that way I get two semicircles there. And then I found these, I think they call them flag terminals. So they have a screw terminal on that end, and then they have a loop. And they're normally meant to crimp onto a wire. But I like the idea that Paul Kennett came up with of using these bullet connectors. And it turns out if you just spread that open a little bit, what I'll do is solder the female bullet connector in here, and then this thing will fit down in here and form like you see here. I guess this is easier to see. So I'll put that flag terminal down on the bottom, put the two wires over the top, and then instead of using a sheet metal screw like that, which I'm not sure how tight that's going to hold, I'm actually going to use a 1 inch long brass screw. And turns out they have a nice square hole right there. So I'm going to get some square nut, put the bolt through there with a washer, and that way I can clamp down really tight. And with this setup, this whole pack will be standalone. I'll just have this with the little bullet connector, and then I can make my jumper wires to go between packs, and I'll solder that onto the end of this thing, so something like that. That way I'll be able to just plug my jumper wires in like that when I get ready to assemble the packs, because with these you have to put the packs side by side, and there's little spacers that go between each group of cells to give you a little bit of a gap. So you have to slide them onto a threaded rod, hook up your jumper wire, slide the next pack on, hook up the next jumper wire, and so on. So I thought that would be a lot easier. And Paul Kennett seems to be having good results with those. So the only other thing I have to do, this terminal doesn't quite fit in there. There's just a tiny little bit too wide and too long. So what I need to do is flatten this rounded side off against a grinding wheel and then knock a little bit of that edge off and knock a little bit of that edge off. And then the other thing I get here, I left the wires a little bit long, so I'm going to crimp on some quick disconnect lugs here on both ends, and I'll use this for the balance cable. So I'll be able to plug in two balance cables, probably one for the BMS on one side, and then plug one in for, say, a monitoring system if I ever want to do that, or I can plug in a cell monitor and monitor the voltage here. So that'll be my plan. I'll make up all of these. And then the only other change I'm going to do from the original design, he set his up where he flipped every other group of cells. So he had the negative next to the positive, and then his jumper wire just ran between here. Well, in my case, I want to keep all of the red side up so I can see my fuse wires. These will be stacked up all the same way. My jumper cable is going to go from down here up to here, and then the next one down will come from right here up to the one next to it. So I'll show you what these look like when I get the rest of the parts and get a couple of them made, and we can see what they look like all together. So just wanted to show you that work in progress, kind of explain what I'm doing. If you have any comments or suggestions or questions, put that in the comment section below there. And I'll put some videos over here on the side you might be interested in. And as always, thanks for watching.